David Archer from Savannah Resources is with me. David, good morning.
Good morning.
Drilling's kicked off then at your lithium project, Mina de Barroso in Portugal. What's the objective here? Remind us.
Well, we're focusing on 3 years, the more promising deposits on the Mina de Barroso mining lease. It's a 5.5 square kilometre mining lease, which is already approved for mining activity. So we're looking at defining resources and defining a JORC resource on the Grandao, Reservatorio and NOA deposits, which already have some amount of drilling on them. So we've got very much a running start to it. Our drilling will look to sort of validate the historical drilling, and we hope to be able to come forward with some JORC resources in the near future as a result of that.
How long do you reckon this will take?
Well, we're sort of reluctant to commit to sort of timelines. Clearly, a lot of the outcomes are dependent both on third-party activities, equipment, and, of course, very importantly, in Europe at the moment, weather conditions. Mm. So, as you know, it's very hot in Europe at the moment. And, in fact, the launch of our drilling program was somewhat delayed because of the very hot conditions, which meant that our teams, from a safety point of view, couldn't go into the field, and also sort of limited our ability to cut lines in preparation for the drill programs. But yeah, we'll certainly be moving forward as quickly as we can with the drilling, bringing it forward to conclusion, getting the assays over to Perth, and coming out with an announcement as soon as we physically are able to do so.
Very good. And as you say, that the mining license, the mining plan, the environmental impact assessment, you've got all those in hand.
Exactly. So it gives us a huge running start at being able to take this project forward into production at a very fast pace.
I suppose quite timely too, given all the talk we've had in the last couple of weeks about this push towards electric vehicles and away from petrol and diesel.
Yeah, exactly. I think the recent news that we've seen both out of the UK and I think even this morning out of France really does sort of highlight this seismic shift that's really accelerating now towards the replacement of existing hydrocarbon fueled vehicle fleets with electric vehicles. I mean, I think it's obviously will be a wonderful thing for Savannah shareholders, but as a London resident, I'd certainly applaud the reduction in belching diesel vehicles from off the road.
And of course, I mean, we mentioned this in the last time we spoke, but being the first lithium producer in Europe, that's something certainly something to get excited about.
Yeah, well, I think it's very consistent with what Europe is trying to do in terms of green energy policies, and certainly the production of lithium in Europe is very sort of consistent with the real major push towards industrial scale storage of electricity in lithium batteries. So what we're doing is very sort of complementary to some of these sort of strategic moves by the European community and other European governments.
Very good, David. Just while I've got you, a couple of other words I'll get you to update us on. Firstly, Mutamba, you're working towards a PFS there at the moment?
Yep, exactly, and we'll have an announcement out updating the market on the status of the PFS. And in Oman as well, we'll be looking to come out with an update specifically around progress on licensing, some of the economics, and where we're at on the resource side in Oman.
That's great, David. Look, thanks very much for taking the time. Good to speak to you.
Thanks. Appreciate it.